Hello everyone, my name is Mafaniso Hara, a professor of natural resource governance at the Institute for Poverty, Land and Agrarian Studies at the University of the Western Cape, South Africa. This presentation is on climate change adaptation in small pelagic and small scale fisheries in South Africa. It is based on a NORAD funded project through the FAO. So what is the background to the project? In South Africa, small pelagics, particularly sardine and anchovy, have historically been the largest volume of fish caught from South African waters and also the largest employer in the fishing sector. Canned sardine is the most popular fish consumed in South Africa. It contributes over 50% of consumed fish. Also, over 60% of South African canned sardine is exported to other African countries. However, there has been a decline in sardine in South African waters in recent years, forcing canneries to import raw sardine for canning. The decline followed geographic shift in availability from the west coast to the south coast in the 1990s to early 2000s. At the same time, there also has been general decline in inshore resources in the west coast and south coast of the Western Cape province. These inshore fish resources are the ones on which small-scale fishers depend on. Both the decline in sardine and inshore resources are thought to be due to climate change factors. So what have been the impacts of these changes? As a result of the drastic decline in sardine catches, most crew members on sardine vessels and factory workers in the sardine canneries have lost jobs and income. To put this into context, up to 80% of people have lost their jobs in the sardines industry since 2010. Regarding small-scale fishers, the low catches and the increase in the required effort being expended to find the fish have also negatively impacted on the small-scale fishing communities. So what is the Climate Change Adaptation Project trying to do? Climate change adaptation activities have been piloted in a number of affected crew member, factory worker, and small-scale fisher communities under a FAO NORAD-funded project in the Western Cape of South Africa. Two sets of activities have been identified for piloting. The first activity involves the use of anchovy for human consumption. The background to this is that currently, all South African anchovy is reduced to fishmeal and fish oil. Also, only about 50% of approximately 300,000 tons of annual total allowable catch is caught. The idea, therefore, is to develop products from South African anchovy for human consumption using this largely underutilized resource. For example, these products could be whole smoked anchovy, whole dried anchovy, anchovy paste, so on and so forth. This will be done through product development and consumer research, and then upscaling of production of those products that consumers accept. Secondly, we have been conducting workshops on the use of marine products such as kelp, shells, etc. to make jewellery, soap, food, and others. This is mostly targeting women. Through the provided kits and skills, the participants can then start their own small-scale businesses based on these products. So what are the expected long-term outcomes? The long-term objective of these climate change adaptation activities is to reduce pressure on the sardine fishery and inshore resources and improve their sustainability through finding and encouraging alternative, complementary and supplementary economic and income activities for the affected communities. Hopefully, this could result in more resilient fishing resources and communities. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you very much. I hope to hear and engage with you on this presentation.